So let's multiply out this bracket and check that it takes us back to the original answer. It's always a good idea to. So 2 times 2a is 4a. That's right. And then 2 times plus 3 is plus 6. Which is the same as the thing I started with. So yes, that is correct. Okay. It will come with practice. Brilliant. And I can see Ruth, Rachel and James, you've all got the correct answer. So well done. Here's some more. I'm going to call these quite simple examples because the two terms involved only share one common factor. So let's have a quick look at part A. 10 minus 5t. Tell me what the common factor is. So I don't want you to factorise it just now. Just tell me what the common factor is. What is the biggest number or letter that divides exactly, that goes exactly into both of those? Brilliant. 5. So 5 goes into 10. And 5 also goes into minus 5t. So it's the 5 that I'm going to put in front of the brackets to do that first. Then I'm going to say to myself, what do I need to multiply that 5 by to get 10? Well, 5 times 2 is 10. So I'll put the 2 inside the bracket. And then what do I need to multiply the 5 by to get minus 5t? Yes, good, good. So isn't perfect, but you don't need the one in front of the t. I just multiply by minus t. So remember, Susan, I'm glad you typed that because I can make that point. When there's the number 1 in front of a letter, you don't need to write it. So remember, we're trying to write this with as few symbols as possible. It's just the way algebra works, and we just try not to. It's not wrong. That's just the way that we write algebra. So 5 times minus t is minus 5t. Check that when you multiply out the bracket, it gets back to the thing we started with. So 5 times 2 is 10. We already know that it's right. And then 5 times minus t is minus 5t. So we're back to where we started. So we know that we are correct if we just do a quick multiplying out at the end just to make sure that we get back to the thing that we started with. Perfect. Good. No, no, Susan, not at all. It's not wrong if you put the one in front. It just takes a little bit of practice that you just don't need it. That's all. All right. So part B, 12w plus 4. Tell me what the common factor is. What is the number that I'm going to put in front of the bracket? Perfect. Excellent. Well done. Oh, Susanna, you're already way ahead. Way ahead. Right. So 4 is the common factor. So put that outside the bracket. Then we ask ourselves, what do I need to multiply 4 by to get 12w? Well, 4 times 3 is 12. And then we've got the W. So to get the W, we need to multiply. So to get the 12W, we need to multiply by 3W. So 3W comes first. And what do I multiply 4 by to get 4, to get plus 4? Well, 4 needs to be multiplied by 1. In this case, we need the 1. There's no letter there, so I have to write the 1 in this case. So I just write plus 1 like that. Perfect. And everyone that's written the answer in there has got it right. Good. Susan, I'm just looking at what you've written. What you've written is actually not wrong. It is correct, but you haven't factorised fully. So when I look at the two terms that you've written in your bracket, so for those of you who are not looking at the chat box, Susan has written, I will explain this because it's not wrong. So Susan has written 2, open bracket, 6 plus 2. 6w plus 2, rather. W's gone a bit squiffy. I'm actually writing this with a mouse, which is why it looks so messy. Now, if I multiply out that bracket, I will get 12w plus 4, so it's not wrong. The problem is, though, is that it's not fully factorised, because if I look at 6w and 2, they share a common factor, because 6 can be divided by 2, and 2 can be divided by 2. So I can take out another common factor. I can take out 2 again. So the problem is you just haven't taken out the highest common factor. You've taken out a factor 2, which is fine and does work. But really, you should take out the factor 4, because that's the biggest number that divides into both 12 and 4. So you factorised it. You just haven't fully factorised it. Is that okay? And do you see why? It's not that it's not wrong. It's just not fully factorised. So that's what we need to do, is take out the biggest number that divides into both. There we go. So it's always a good idea if you have written your factorisation to check the two terms in the bracket and make sure that they don't share any common factors either within the numbers or the letters. And then we've got part C. We've got 3c take away c squared. What is the highest common factor? What is the term that I'm going to put in front of the bracket? CC. Yes, everyone's writing C. There isn't a number that is common to these two, but there is a letter. So we're going to put C in front of the bracket. And then it just works in exactly the same way. What do I need to multiply C by to get 3C? I multiply it by 3. So the 3 comes first inside my bracket. And then what do I need to multiply C by to get minus C squared? Remember that C squared is C times C. Plus I need a minus because it's got a minus sign in front of it. So C times minus C is minus C squared. So that's what goes into my bracket. If you want to check it, you can multiply the bracket, but you should get back to what you started with. Is that okay? Good. Okay. I know that some people will be finding this difficult, but you'll just have to spend a lot more time doing practice. Please don't be put off. Just to give you an idea, there are 17 people watching this live lesson, and it's not because 5 people have typed the answer on the screen. The other 12 people might not really know how to do it yet, but don't worry. It's like when you're at school and you look around and everyone else seems to be able to do it and you can't. It might just be that the people that are typing this up have done this before. Some people will have done it before and some people will never have done it before. So don't assume that because other people can do it and you can't, that, you know, it just means that you need to do a little bit more practice.